Hi, my name is Dr. Jay Desai, and I welcome you all to this 13th video on GATE series for metallurgical engineering. In this video, I'm talking about iron carbon diagram, and more specifically, I'm talking about iron carbide system, alpha ferrite, austenite, and delta ferrite. Now, what is an iron carbon phase diagram? So the iron carbon phase diagram can be divided into two parts. The first part is iron carbide, that is Fe3C system. Now in this system, the carbon presence varies from 0 to 6.7 weight percent. And all the steels and cast irons that are commercially produced fall in this category. It's a two component system. The first component is iron, and the second component is iron carbide or cementite. Now, the second part of the iron carbon phase diagram is iron carbide graphite system, where the carbon presence is over 6.7 weight percent. But in this video, we'll only talk about iron carbide system. Now, this is how the iron carbide system looks like. It has two components, but it has different phases: alpha ferrite, austenite, delta ferrite, perlite, leduberite, and cementite or iron carbide. Now these phases occurs at different temperature ranges and different carbon concentration. So this iron carbide system has iron over here, which is pure iron, 100% iron, and this is how we are adding carbon. So this is the concentration of carbon, this is the temperature, and these are the different phases that are formed in iron carbide system. So let's talk about the three types of iron that are formed. The first one is, we call it as alpha ferrite. This iron occurs in the temperature range of 0 to 911 degrees centigrade. As you can see from here, this is your alpha ferrite region. Now this alpha ferrite has a BCC crystal structure, and since it has BCC crystal structure, the shape and size of the BCC interstitials are such that they do not allow the carbon accommodation easily, and that is why the maximum carbon solubility which alpha ferrite have is only 0.02 weight percent. Now, as we move up in the temperature range, we have austenite or gamma ferrite. Here the temperature range is 911 degree centigrade to 1392 degree centigrade. Means austenite is stable in this temperature range. Now this austenite has a FCC crystal structure, and the FCC interstitials are larger than BCC interstitials, and that is why they can accommodate more carbon atoms. And since they can accommodate more carbon atoms, they have over 100 times more carbon solubility than the alpha iron. And that is why maximum carbon solubility in austenite is 2.14 weight percent. Then when we move above 1392 degrees centigrade, we get a phase called delta ferrite. And this phase of iron occurs in the temperature range of 1392 to 1536. This is also a BCC crystal, or it also has a BCC crystal structure. But this delta ferrite is not of any practical significance, as we do not use it in a real life scenario. And also the carbon solubility is limited to only 0.09 weight percent. Now, one may ask, what is the difference between alpha ferrite, which was forming in 0 to 911 degree centigrade, and the delta ferrite, which is occurring in 1392 to 1536 degree centigrade temperature range? So they both are similar, they both have BCC crystal structure. The only thing is the range of temperature over which they exist. So all the three phases, alpha ferrite, austenite, and delta ferrite, they are all the forms of iron, but they occur at different temperature ranges. And mostly we use gamma ferrite or austenite when we are taking the deformation processes, as we know that FCC is more ductile. So if we can convert iron into the austenite state from the BCC state, then we can deform iron and we can make products which we really desire. And that is the significance of all the three forms of iron: alpha ferrite, gamma ferrite or austenite, and delta ferrite. I hope you like my video, and to watch more videos and support my work, please subscribe to my channel. In the next video, I will be continuing the discussion on iron carbon diagram, and I will talk about the perlite phase, the ladubrite phase, cementite, bainite and martensite. How are they formed? Why are they formed? And if we want to get this, what should we do? If you have any topic suggestions, as a viewer or subscriber, it is welcome. And if you have any suggestions or queries on the content, or if you have a possible opening or collaboration, then you can reach out to me on my LinkedIn page, via email, or by commenting in the YouTube video. Thank you.